Hello friends, welcome back. In this video I'm going to discuss how to do the loft float trick. This is used to get floor items up to higher levels, like on top of your loft, or to raise partitions. So the first thing you're going to need to do is be in mouse and keyboard mode, because you're going to need access to the rotate selected object option and the place selected object in your inventory option. The best way for me to explain this is you are going to need a lift device. In this case, it's going to be the loft, spare loft. Keep it in your inventory. And you're going to need something for that lift device to connect to. You can't connect to baseboards anywhere where there is a baseboard on a wall, so those don't work. And until you get past that portion, you won't be able to use the wall that you're next to. So I have brought in a stage panel for this purpose. I picked the stage panel because, again, it has no baseboard on it, which makes doing this a lot easier. So my recommendation is to be patient until you get a feel for this, and I will explain it as best I can. So if you bring your loft out of your inventory and you use your mouse button, your left mouse click, you can place it, right? Which we don't want it placed. And I'm going to turn on this place selected object item in your inventory so I don't have to continue opening my subcommands menu to do that. Clicking it will just dump it right back in my inventory. Be careful with that you don't accidentally click back into place the item you're trying to lift. That's a pain in the butt. So if you bring your loft back out of your inventory and you hit escape on your keyboard, it sends it back to your inventory. So the idea is to do these things at the same time, like a clutch on your car. You're going to need to click it in place and then hit escape. You can click and hold, and then right as you're letting go of the mouse button, hit escape. I find that a little bit easier to think of it in that way. Instead of click escape, I'm clicking and then letting go escape. And you can see how it's pushing the object up into the air. If the timing is perfect, it will automatically send my lift device back into my inventory, which is super convenient. When you're working with bigger objects, I might be able to do, see, I can jump it up really high, which is good. If you're working with something like a rug, you might only be able to do small increments. And just to kind of zoom in, you want the surface, the top surface of your lift device, to be just above, at least just above the bottom. So here's the bottom of your hitbox on your furniture. You want to be just above that. And you click escape. And you keep doing that until you get all the way up to where you want it to go. When you are done doing that and you have it to where you want it, at that point you're going to need to lock the items into place so they don't fall back down upon your next entry into your house. So to do that, I'm just going to get him up the rest of the way. If you get to a point where you no longer can put your loft within another loft, just bring out the one you were using and can lift that back up. If you get it too high and maybe you didn't want it to be quite that high, you can put your lift device slightly under and it'll pull it back down a little bit. So the next and final step is to do the locking in place. So go back into your indoor furnishings mode and click on your rotate selected object. Grab the object you lifted. It's in rotate mode, so all you have to do is just rotate it and lock it into place, and then rotate it back however you want it. One rotation in any direction of any degree will lock the item in place, and that is how you do a lift of furnishings. If you would like to lift a partition, you can do the same thing, or what I personally like to do, I think that this is way easier. Oops, let me turn on my move selected objects is to use a beam. And you can put a beam as low as you can. Turn off snap grid, that helps sometimes. As low as you can on your wall. And instead of using a loft to do the lift, you're going to use a shelf to do the lift. So I have some extra Riviera shelves. They need to be in your inventory. Again, this trick pulls the item from your inventory, not from your storage. With partitions, you can't lift from the edges. You need to lift from the middle of the partition. So it's going to be the same thing. I am going to line my shelf up as low as I can. If I try to go too high, it's probably not going to work. Like, that doesn't work. So if you go low, and if you go too far over, it's going to try to snap to the wall, which you don't want. So just go as far over as you can. And again, you're going to click and let go escape. And it shoves the wall upwards. Depending on the item you're using, I think I already said this, will depend on how much you can push it up at a single time. So if it doesn't work, you know, just be patient, or, you know, find a different angle to do that. Again, if you're lifting any item, you need to rotate it. So I turned on my rotate selected object, and then rotate it back to where I want it. Now it is locked in place. Something to be aware of, there is a height limit and a low height limit. So for example, if you have it too high up to the ceiling, you might actually push it into the next floor. It will ping to the next floor. If you have it too low to the floor, it might just drop right back down. So it's up to you to find out what the item you're lifting, how far up you need it to go before it will stay in place. And that can be very frustrating, especially when you want it to be a low float. You are not always going to be able to do that. So that is my tutorial on how to do loft lifts. And here's an example of a bunch of my loft lifts to make a custom doorway upstairs, which I will show you in another video. Have a good day and happy designing.